I'd like to introduce my new UWB project. On the left is an ESP32S3 with a new UWB module connected along with an SPI display. You can see the initialization of the UWB module taking place. Once the initialization process is complete, the graphical interface will launch. It's continuously searching for tech device internally and has made it possible to check the distance to communicate with the tech device. It was built based on LVGL version 8, and you can check out tutorials about LVGL and SQLite Studio on my channel. This is a new tech device created in this project. This has only a battery connected to the tech module, and the battery uses CR2032. There is an on and off switch on the battery holder, so you can easily turn it on and off. The reason I can only connect the power like this is because I set the device through AT commands, and this is stored in flash memory, so there's no need for separate initialization. So once you complete the settings, you can connect the battery and use it. So good. This is the beginning of a new UWB project, and I believe there will be many more to try. Let's start one by one. Let's talk about UWB chips. So far, most of the UWB chips available to us in the market are Corvus DWM3s. As far as I know, Corvus products are used in many commercial projects. In addition, the DWM3000 can communicate with the iPhone's U1 chip. Maybe it's possible with iPhone's new U2 chip as well. Anyway, enabling a wider variety of applications. But it takes a lot of time and effort to use it properly. At a hobby level though, using this without a library that gives you full control is not easy. This new one, this UWB module made by some Taiwanese company is, on the contrary, too easy. It can be connected to the MCU through UART, and the device can be set up through serial AT commands. Since all settings are stored inside the chip, the UWB module can be used on its own with one setup. This is a very convenient chipset. But as you know, there are always pros and cons. The problem is that there is little we can do. Usually UWB settings include several settings. There are kind of RX, TX power settings, frequency settings, bandwidth, preamble, buffer size, etc. However, because this has simplified everything, only the essential parts can be set. Well, this is enough though. Now let's look at actually setting up and using this UWB module. First, I'm going to set up the tag device. This tag device, like Apple's AirTag, once set up, we'll continue to have the same settings and we'll try to turn on and off with an external power source. To input serial commands to this device, we need to connect through FTDI USB to serial. Now open the serial monitor and enter the commands we need. I'm going to use the manual provided by the manufacturer. This sets to act as a tech device. This specifies the network ID, ensuring that only devices on the same network communicate. This sets a unique address for this device. This must be unique. This specifies the network's passkey. Without this, it will not be able to connect to the specified network. Finally, you can send messages from tech device. Here, 5 represents the ranks of the message to be sent. Once you set this up, the tech device is ready to go. This will continue to send the send message, and when the anchor device is ready, you can receive data as well as the physical distance between the two devices through it. Now let's set up the anchor device. The tech device operates independently by connecting a battery, just like an AirTag. On the other hand, the anchor device uses information received from the tech device to display the distance between the two devices on the screen. The device used in this project is WT32SC01 Plus. It has an ESP32S3 MCU and a capacitive touchscreen as well. If you look at my channel, you can see that I have used this device in many projects. This device is connected to the UWB module through serial 2, and this connector was created for easy connection. This is a code used in the Anchor device. You can download this code from my GitHub repository. I'm using LVGL when I need a GUI. This can provide a great user interface even in an MCU environment. If you need more information about LVGL, please refer to the previous project video. Here, the first thing to do is initialize serial. I'm using serial for debugging and serial 2 to communicate with the UWB module. The UWB initialization function was performed according to the same manual as when setting up the previous tech device. The next one is, as this UWB task continues to run, the data is sent to the tech device, and the distance from the string data can be known from the data received from the tech device. You can see that only the distance part from the string is substringed. Let's check the UWB connection. First on the right is the anchor device. After startup, initialization set in the code is performed. Let me power on the tech device. Did you see it? As soon as the tech device is turned on, the anchor device gets it. It was super fast. According to the datasheet, the distance error is plus minus 10 centimeters, but I believe this is apt calibration. I haven't calibrated yet, but I did first set up a basic test environment. The actual valid distance test and power consumption test will probably be done in the next project. The UWB module is very interesting. Through communication, the physical distance between two modules can be known, and through this, very different applications can be developed. This project is one I did previously using four anchor modules and one tech module. The purpose of this project is to project the position information from real space into a virtual 3D coordinate system using a UWB module. Because it was made using only very simple parts, there are a lot of things to be improved, but I was able to see the result I wanted. I'm looking forward to seeing what variety of projects will be possible with this new UWB module. Stay tuned. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.